After that last game, I was feeling kind of bad, you know? I was thinking you might think the game's just rigged because I never showed you my number. I'm a good guy, so I decided we'd play another game, and this time I'd show you my number at the end. So here's how this game's gonna work. And keep in mind, this is gonna be a good game because if you win, I'm gonna send you and your whole family right off to Disney World. All right, now here's how this game goes. You're gonna pick a number from 0 to 1. All right, we're gonna call your number X. And you can pick any number from 0 to 1. You can pick 0. You can pick 1. You can pick a half. You can pick a third. You can pick pi divided by 10, or the square root of 2 minus 1. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to pick a number from 0 to 1. And while your number is called X, mine's going to be called Y. And the way you win is... I'm going to tell you how you're going to win. First, we're going to pick the numbers. All right, and we're going to write them down this time. We'll write them down, and then at the end, we'll then show each other numbers. I have nothing on my board yet. I'm going to write my number down right now. So you write your number down. Don't show it to me yet. I'm going to write my number down, but no peeking. All right, here we go. Let's see a number. Oh. Let's see. That's a good number. All right, I've got my number. You got your. Don't show it to me yet. All right, we're going to talk about this a little bit more. See how it is you win, and then we will show each other our numbers. All right, now, the way you win, and then I send you and your family off to Disney World, is if X, your number, plus 2 times my number, is greater than 1. All right, if this happens, so if you picked a half and I picked 2/3 and we end up greater than 1, you're going to Disney World. So let's see, what are the number? No, I'm not going to show you my number yet. You know, we've got to do a math problem here. We've got to find the probability that if we each chose randomly, that you would win. Because I'm sure you chose at random, and I chose at random too. So what's the probability that you win? Well, our usual way of doing probability is the number of successes divided by the number of possible. But, well, we have a problem here. The number of possibles is infinite because, well, you have infinitely many choices from 0 to 1, and so do I. So our usual way of just number of successes divided by number of possible isn't going to work. We're going to have to find some other way to measure the possible space. And the same thing is true of our successes. There are infinitely many ways that you can have success and go off to Disney World on my dime. So let's see, how are we going to measure this? Number of ways you can pick a number from 0 to 1, number of ways I can pick from 0 to 1. Well, we could try plotting them on the number line, but it's not so clear what we would do about this condition, x plus 2, y greater than 1 on the number line. However, the x and the y, well, they do suggest another way we can look at this problem. Sometimes pictures are very revealing in problems, so let's go ahead and draw a picture here. The x and the y suggest, well, let's try graphing. And we'll put the x here in the x-axis. That's your number. And it can be anywhere from 0 to 1. And go ahead and mark 0.5 as well. Then here's my number up here, y. And that also goes from 0 to 1. And I'll go ahead and mark the 0.5 as well. And let's see, first we'll get a good picture of the possible region. And well, I can pick any number from 0 to 1, and so can you. So our possible region is just this box. You know, if you pick 1 and I pick a half, that's right there, and you're going to Disney World. If you pick 0 and I pick 0.2, well, that's right about there, and you're not going to Disney World. Or if you pick a half and I pick 0.3, that's right about there, yay, you're going to Disney World. So we have a good idea of our possible region here. A nice picture of it, it's a square, and we know how to measure this region. And now we see how we're going to compute our probability. Our probability is going to be the area of success divided by the area of the possible region. And the possible region's easy. It's a square, side length 1, its area is 1. But what about our successful region? What does that look like? Well, the way we're going to figure that out is to graph this. And the way we'll graph this is first we'll think about, well, what are the boundary points? Where are the points where you just barely miss going to Disney World because x plus 2y equals 1. If it equals 1, sorry, not going to Disney World. At least not on my dime. So where's x plus 2y equal to 1? Well, if you pick 1 and I pick 0, that's right here, then x plus 2y equals 1. If you pick a half and I pick a quarter, then we'll have x plus 2y equals 1. That's right about here. If you pick 0 and I pick a half, x plus 2y equals 1. And if we just connect these, we get a line here. And this line represents all the possibilities where you just miss going to Disney World because x plus 2y equals 1. So where are the successes? Where are the points that represent you going to Disney World on my dime? They sound like success to you, not so much to me, but let's see. This is where x plus 2y equals 1. We need x plus 2y to be a little bit more, well, you need x plus 2y to be a little bit more than 1, and you can get there by increasing x or by increasing y. So if you start from here and you increase x or increase y, you're going to Disney World because x plus 2y will be greater than 1. And that's this region up here. All these points up here is your successful region. And down here is no good for you. And if you decrease y or decrease x from where x plus 2y equals 1, you're not going to Disney World because then you'll be less than 1. So this is the bad region for you, and this is the good region. And the question is, what's the area of this? There are a lot of ways to find this area. Probably the easiest is to find the area of the white triangle and subtract from 1. The whole square is 1. This triangle, it's a right triangle. One leg is 1, the other leg is a half. The area is half the product of the legs for a right triangle, so 1 half times 1 half times 1, that's a quarter, which leaves 3 quarters for our successful region. Another way you could have seen that is just, if you just continue this line all the way across, these two rectangles, the bottom rectangle and the top rectangle, are the same. So this bottom rectangle is half the whole square, and the bad triangle is half the bottom rectangle. So the bad triangle is half of half the square is a quarter of the square, which means the good area is 3/4 of the whole square. So the success area that's sending you off to Disney World is 3/4. So the probability that you win and you and your family are going to Disney World and Art of Problem Solving is paying for it is 3/4. It's really good. It's much better than the other game we played. So now the moment of truth. All right, you ready? On the count of three, we're going to reveal our numbers. And we'll find out if you're going to Disney World. All right, you ready? 1, 2, 3. Better luck next time. Thank you.